we can now go to our blocks. And what we want to do is, for the personal classifier, first thing we want to do is wait until it's ready. The classifier is going to start up, and it will signal to us when it's ready to accept images and try to classify them. So what I want to do then is change my label to say something like ready to classify. And then the other thing I'm going to do is go back to the designer and make my button disabled. So if I uncheck this enabled button, the button won't be enabled until we're all ready to go. So let's go back here and set classifier button enabled to true at this point, right? So it'll say ready to classify, the button will become enabled, and then the user can start taking pictures. So when they click on the button, we're going to take them out to the camera and have the camera take a picture. Then the camera will signal to us or to the app that it's taken the picture when it's all completed, and it sends back the actual image. So what we want to then do is call the personal image classifier and say, hey, can you classify this image and let me know what it is? Is it healthy or diseased? Then in turn, the personal image classifier gives us a classification, or it triggers an event when it's got the classification. And the classification comes in a result. Now, the result comes in kind of a weird format, and it's something that can be called a dictionary. So this is what a dictionary looks like, and it really is a set of keys and values. And in our case, it's going to have the key, which will be our labels. So one will be healthy, and the other one will be diseased. These will be spelled exactly as we labeled them in the classifier. And then the value is going to be its confidence level, and it will be a number between 0 and 1. So it's going to be a decimal. So it would be something like, this is an example, 7834. So 0.7834 is 78.34% confidence. So 1 would be complete confidence, 0 would be no confidence. And then let's duplicate that. And then the second number would be probably something either higher or lower. So we're going to do, this might be 2185. So that would be 21% confidence that it's diseased. So in this case, it thinks it's healthy because that's a bigger number than diseased. This is what the result will look like. It's going to be this dictionary with keys and values. So what we're going to do is test if, and what we can do is go to dictionary and say get value for key healthy in result. So that's going to be our dictionary. And from the math, we're going to grab this equals and change it to greater than. So we're going to say, well, is the value that we get for healthy greater than, and I'm going to duplicate this, is it greater than the value I'm going to get for diseased? And if it is, what we're going to do is set the label to tell us that. So we're going to say classification is going to say this citrus is healthy. And in the other case, it would mean that it's diseased, right? So we're going to say this citrus is diseased. I am ready to test. So what I'm going to do now is connect to, I'm going to reset my connection. And I'm going to connect to the AI companion. Unfortunately, the emulator won't work with the personal image classifier. And this is because the hardware required to get the personal image classifier to work isn't enough in the emulator. So you can only do it with a phone. And not every phone will work. So this is a good thing to check to make sure that it's going to work for you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start up my companion on my phone. I'm going to scan the QR code. This is a mirror image in my phone, so you can see what's going on. Okay, it takes a bit, but here we go. So I'm going to identify the citrus. And it says ready to classify, so the classifier is ready. I'm going to identify the citrus. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take pictures that I have from my set here. So here's a black spot. So let me make this bigger. All right, so let's take a picture of this. And then what I'm going to do is just uncover this so you can see. In the camera app, I'm going to say, yes, that's my picture. And it says this citrus is diseased. So that one works. Let's try another one. So I'm going to say identify citrus. And in this case, let's go to a healthy one. So I'll go to healthy and pick out a healthy picture. Let's try this and make it big enough so I can take a picture of it. And again, let's see what this looks like. The citrus is healthy. Great. So this is the idea behind it, and certainly you'd want to go and test with multiple pictures. You might even get some fruit yourself and take pictures. This is an example of what you can do with App Inventor and the personal image classifier. You train your model with the classifier website. You download your model. Then within App Inventor, you upload your model for the personal image classifier component, which is an extension, and then you can go ahead and your app now becomes a mobile citrus identifier. So good job on this. This gives you the general idea of how it works. One possible enhancement to this would be, you know, you could add video as the input mode and then allow it to take video. And so a farmer could be out in the fields and using their video to identify whether or not their plants are diseased or not. But this is an example of the image classifier, and hopefully this gives you some ideas for what you might be able to do with App Inventor and your AI app.